Thank you for joining us for today's Illinois Tollway Building for Success webinar series. If you have joined us previously, welcome back. If this is your first time tuning into our weekly series, we're glad you set aside time in your busy day to spend with us. I'd like to go over some housekeeping items before we begin today's presentation. First, everyone will be muted. If you would like to submit a question, please use the chat box function and include your name and company affiliation so we know who you are. If you are joining us via phone or computer or laptop, the presentation will be recorded and posted on the Tollway's website afterwards. And finally, please take a few moments to fill out a brief survey following the presentation. We appreciate your feedback and would love to hear how you learned about today's event and if you have suggestions for future topics. The Department of Diversity and Strategic Development is a driving force for economic opportunities in the diverse communities we serve. Through our various programs and initiatives, the Tollway takes an active role in providing access to economic opportunities for small, diverse, and veteran businesses and individuals in the heavy highway construction industry. Today, the department is heavily focused on increasing training and education opportunities like today's webinar, working with internal departments to identify economic opportunities for diverse firms, recruiting new entrants, and supporting programs and initiatives for historically underserved individuals. Today's webinar series topic is Small Business Initiative Contract Administration. Today's presenters are Marlene Vick, General Manager of Diversity, and Laura Thompson from the Illinois Tollway Engineering as a Senior Project Engineer. We have over 100 people registered for the webinar, so there's a fair amount of interest in this topic. Now I'll turn it over to Marlene.
Hello, everyone, and thank you for attending today's weekly webinar. As Kristen said, we are excited about today's topic and hope that it provides the information you need as a new prime contractor on tollway projects. Before we get to the heart of the presentation, I'll begin with a quick overview of the SBI program. Chances are you've attended a prior webinar on SBI, or you've already bid on one of the more than 20 SBI contracts we've advertised since January of this year. So if you're looking for more detailed information on the Tollway's SBI program and beyond today's webinar, including a list of upcoming contracts, please visit the Doing Business section of the Tollway's website at illinoistollway.com. The Tollway Small Business Initiative Program provides new prime and subcontracting opportunities exclusively for registered small businesses. And unlike the traditional small business set-aside contract we advertise, SBI contracts will have DBE goals and minimum self-performance goals, both to help give diverse contractors opportunities to gain experience while delivering Move Illinois program contracts on our behalf. SBI projects are concentrated in areas that we believe will result in interest and competition from the small business community, including demolition, electrical, vertical, structural, landscaping, grading and drainage, and general roadway construction. SBI initiative contracts fall into three tiers: 1 million or less, 1 to 3 million, and 3 million and more. In order to perform on SBI contracts, both primes and subs must be registered small businesses with the state of Illinois and register in the Tollway Small Business Program, SBI program, I'm sorry. We're excited about this program because it provides the types of work necessary to allow small businesses to grow and succeed as either primes or subs. That's a very brief overview of the SBI program. If you're looking for more detailed overview, we invite you to visit Diversity's homepage at illinoistollway.com for more on SBI projects, including past webinars that covered this topic. So with that, I'll turn the presentation over to Laura Thompson, who will discuss the next steps in contract award. Laura?
Thanks, Marlene. Just a little background about me. I've been with the Tollway for about 8 years, and I've managed a number of design and construction projects of different sizes and complexities. I have a history of working with some small business set-aside contracts, as well as working with firms that have been new to the Tollway. So with that, I'm really excited about today's presentation, and I hope it will provide some clarity of what is expected when a Tollway construction project starts up. So you may have been awarded a contract with the Tollway. So what is next, you may ask? Upon receipt of all of the contract required documents, the Tollway will issue a notice to proceed letter. But there is no need to worry because the Tollway is here to help you along the way. As the project begins, you'll be connected with an assigned engineering project manager who will assist in monitoring the construction project in close connection with the CM and CCM entities. The Tollway project manager is your primary Tollway contact and will often help you submit the documentation needed to obtain your notice to proceed. As the contractor, you will be primarily in contact with the assigned construction manager, the CM. The CM will help to resolve contract issues, coordinate paperwork, and confirm work is being completed in accordance with the contract plans and specifications. Depending on the project, a corridor construction manager, a CCM, may also be assigned to the project. Like the large central tri-state, the Elgin O'Hare Western Access, or even some of the system-wide improvements, the CCM will be there to provide consistency amongst numerous projects. The Tollway will organize a pre-construction meeting to introduce the contractor to the contract administrators and participating departments. The pre-construction meeting will cover such topics as contract overview, project restrictions, the Illinois State Police District 15, traffic controls and procedures, the chain of communication. We'll also go over the coordination with maintenance facilities and other agencies, how to submit the Tollway utility locate process, the required contractor submittals. We'll also cover the contractor working hours and restrictions, as well as the diversity program overviews, and even touch on the web-based project management. Oftentimes, the Tollway will host additional pre-construction meetings specific to the scope of the contract, such as a material, earthwork, erosion control, ICS, and business systems. This will allow for a deeper dive into the contract-specific work and allow the Tollway, prime contractors, and subcontractors an opportunity to gain clarification on specific scope and understanding. One of the first activities that the contractor must complete is the submittal and approval of the A15 process, also known as the subcontractor approval. The contractor will be responsible to submit this for every sub prior to that subcontractor starting on-site activities. The submittal is completed through the Tollway's web-based project management system, eBuilder. Financial disclosures are needed for any subcontractor over $50,000 and are also submitted and reviewed as part of this process. Subcontractors will be reviewed for delinquent debt and related experience. Subcontractors cannot start work with any delinquent debt, so that must be resolved. The contractor typically cannot subcontract more than 65% of the contract work. If there is a change in this requirement, it will be included in the SP 124 of your Volume 2. Subcontractors must be registered with the state and the Tollway, or a small business exception must be submitted. While the SBI contracts are solely intended for contractors registered with the state and the Tollway as a small business, there may be limited occasions, where a prime contractor cannot identify a sufficient small business to complete all subcontracted work. With that, the prime contractor must then submit a written request for a small business exception. The request must document the scope of the work for which small business participation is not available and the efforts the prime contractor took to engage small businesses to perform that scope of work. The Tollway will make no guarantees on the approval of the SBE request. and strongly encourages that the contractors utilize the approved small business sub. All tollway contracts will require a baseline schedule to be completed within 14 days of notice to proceed. While our current specifications have a specific requirement to utilize scheduling software Primavera P6, SBI subcontractors are encouraged to request a waiver to this use depending on the magnitude and complexity of the project. We often find that software programs, including Microsoft Excel, will provide enough information to the tollway to monitor the progress. Within the project schedule, there will be elements needed, such as the notice to proceed, any interim completion dates, the substantial completion, and the contract completion. These are a few examples, but we will also need an accompanying schedule narrative. The contractor should review the tollway supplemental SP108.02 for further clarification on these requirements. All projects will have weekly progress meetings with the CM, CCM, and the tollway. At these meetings, the contractor will review the upcoming work and provide at least a two-week look ahead. This is often shown in a Microsoft Excel format and will allow the tollway and CM to plan their operations and support appropriately. Pay estimates, everybody's favorite. Construction pay estimates are processed monthly, and upon request to the CM can be processed bi-weekly. All pay estimates are processed electronically by the tollway. Payments are typically processed by the tollway, excluding the state of Illinois issuance of that check, on average within 14 days of the submittal of the web-based project management. The first pay estimate will be drafted and submitted for partial payment of mobilization upon the baseline schedule submittal. So with that, mobilization will be paid up to 4.5% of the contract value is paid after that baseline schedule is submitted. Any remaining amount and up to 6% of that contract value is paid after 10% of the contract is complete. One important item to note, if the contractor's mobilization line item exceeds 6% of the contract value, the remainder of that line item would not be paid out until 85% of the contract is complete. The second pay estimate will not be issued until approval of that contractor baseline schedule. As noted earlier, this is required within 14 days of your notice to proceed. A few other items to note regarding payment. Allowance items may be included on any contract and often have a unit designation. These line items establish a budget for specific work that may have not been identified at the time of bid. The allowance items are not guaranteed to the contractor and will only be used at the discretion of the engineer. The contractor quality program tends to be an often question. This must be submitted within 14 days of notice to proceed through the eBuilder application. The submittal must be in accordance with the tollway's contractor quality program manual, which can be found on the tollway's website under Doing Business Manuals Contractor Manual. This line item is established by the tollway on all contracts prior to advertisement. This line item is paid to the contractor on a percent complete of the contract value and with successful adherence to the contractor's plan and submittal. Last item to note, material allowances will be considered for non-perishable materials exceeding $10,000, for materials not expected to be included in the work for 60 days. So this is in place to help you bridge the gap for some of those costly upfront and advanced purchases. A form must be completed and provided by the CM to process with the pay estimate. We will also need a canceled check. The tollway is required by the trust indenture to include 10% of the paid amount until the project is 50% complete. Upon 50% completion, no additional retainage is withheld from your payment. The tollway will release additional retainage after substantial completion and provided the value is not less than twice the remaining work, but also not less than $20,000. After final completion and all final documents are submitted, the remainder of your retainage is paid to the contractor. So I've mentioned eBuilder a number of times. We utilize this as the tollway's current web-based project management system. This program is a web-based application utilized for contract administration. Nearly all processing of the contract will be completed through this application. The tollway hosts a short training for this application on a regular basis, and it can be requested at any time after contract award. This will be covered more in the pre-construction meeting. But remember, the program is very user-friendly, and your construction manager is there to help you through all of the details throughout the course of the project. Our team also has an established general email at ebuilder@getitas.com for additional support throughout the project. The iMears program is used for quality assurance and quality control for uploading asphalt, concrete, and aggregate testing reports. Training is available upon request for this program. All documentation that is uploaded is checked by the tollway CM and the materials IA inspector. The B2G Now software tracks payments and subcontractors, payments to subcontractors, DBE, and VOSB participation. Prime and subcontractors have access to review and track their payments for work performed and to upload their certified payroll. A diversity webinar has been previously completed for the B2G Now tracking system, and this can be referenced on the tollway's website. Additionally, a compliance analyst will also be assigned to the project. This will be your main point of contact for reporting the tollway's compliance department. For project closeout, primes must ensure that all subs are paid for all work performed prior to that final release of retainage. This is checked in that B2G Now tracking system. So Capture is our software that tracks our EEO participation on a contract. The diversity webinar series is planning an upcoming webinar on this topic to provide additional guidance. So be on the lookout. On behalf of the tollway's engineering department, I would like to thank you for tuning into this week's diversity webinar series. I really hope that this information provided you some beneficial to you and or has been beneficial to you and your firm. We have a panelist from engineering, including Pete Fornsler, Jim Mayer with Tollway PMO, as well as myself. We have Donna Williams from compliance, or sorry, from procurement. And I'm not sure if we had someone jump on from compliance. Okay. We also have Marlene Vick and Kristen Bennett from diversity. If there's any questions, we are here to answer them. Lorena?
Thank you so much, Laura and Marlene. Great presentation. And like Laura said, please take advantage of this opportunity. We've got engineering, diversity, and some procurement representatives in the panel to ask some questions. I do have questions coming in already. So with that said, only the Q&A section and the chat function are available. So I'll go ahead and address those questions as they come in. The first question is, tollway contracts are different from IDOT, or are they one in the same?
So tollway has their own projects as well as IDOT has their own. So we do have two separate organizations. We do overlap in some of our specifications, but yes, separate contracts.
Thank you, Laura. Contractor quality plan. Can you please expand? How can we get more details?
So the contractor quality plan, if you go under doing business and then contractor manuals and then manuals, there'll be a contractor quality program manual, which will really spell out what that quality plan is. So typically in there, you'll find what the testing record or requirements are for a lot of your asphalt, concrete, and such, as well what requirements those testing folks on your team are required to have. So it'll go into significant detail, and we also have our materials department and our quality program that can walk you through any steps you have once you get your contract. So we will, if there's more questions on it, we can surely elaborate at a later date with it. Maybe I like these presentations, so I like to volunteer topics. Can you tell? With more topics if we need to. So.
Thank you, Laura. There's a follow-up question to that. Is there also a manual for pay estimates?
Jim, I think that's in the Tollway supplemental specification, correct?
Yeah, the requirement for pay estimates are covered in the Tollway supplemental specification. There is not a separate manual for pay estimates. The construction manager that the Tollway has that will monitor the work and measure the quantities, and then they will submit a pay estimate to the contractor for review. So the contractor does not need to generate that pay estimate. The Tollway CM does that and then submits it for the to the contractor for their review.
Thank you, guys. I have another question here. Is there someone a contractor can call into for asking questions regarding requirements for small business initiative bid submittals? In particular, bid guarantee versus bid bond needing to be submitted with bid in order to be considered responsive.
I would suggest one of the resources that the Tollway has is the technical assistance program. They can assist you with putting your bid together and also helping you with your bid bond and what is considered to be responsive. Also, please note that there is a checklist with every project that tells you what is needed and what is required to be submitted. They'll walk you through that. And I'll put the information, the link to our diversity homepage there.
Thank you, Marlene. I did see a question in regards to the slides. For everyone in the audience, this presentation is being recorded and it will be posted to the webinar series page on the Tollway's website along with the presentation. With that said, I've got a couple more questions coming in. Is there a small business exception in actual form, or is this something that is written to as a request to the Tollway?
Right now we have it as a request to the Tollway. We are putting together a form so that we can sort of walk you through it with all of the steps for the request, and what you need to submit are in the special provisions. That's right, are in the SBI special provisions. I think section 8.6.
Thank you, Marlene. For those of you in the audience, if you have questions, please submit them via the Q&A or the chat function. I've got some more questions here. You mentioned a number of pre-construction meetings in your presentation. Will all of these be required for every contract?
So no, the main pre-construction meeting will detail out what subsequent pre-construction meetings will be necessary. So for instance, a landscaping job would also have an erosion control pre-construction where you'll go into more details of what will be required. You'll walk the site. And you'll have a lot of questions answered from the independent, the ISI firm. So, but you'll also, just for another example, a plaza contract will likely have a business systems pre-construction meeting, but not an erosion control meeting. So it'll really depend on the scope of the project.
Thank you, Laura. There was a mention that a subcontractor had to provide financial information before the work begins, and that they cannot be delinquent debt. Should the prime verify that a prime has no delinquent debt before they're considered a subcontractor? Do you want me to repeat it? It was kind of long-winded. There was a mention that a subcontractor had to provide financial information before the work begins and that there cannot be any delinquent debt. Should the prime verify that a prime has not delinquent debt before they are considered to be a sub? I think they mean, should the prime verify that the sub has no delinquent debt?
The delinquent debt can be resolved after the fact. So while it would be beneficial to check that before, it can be resolved later. You will come across this if your sub that's called out on your called out at the time of bid has delinquent debt. We'll resolve that before notice to proceed is issued. And then if it's a subcontractor that also is not included in that early paperwork, it will come up in your A15 process. Well, they'll check that delinquent debt again. But like I said, there's a couple of ways to get that checked and resolved. It won't necessarily hold up your contract from being issued.
Thank you, Laura. Do you require bond for 1 million or less projects?
Yeah, I can probably jump in there and maybe Dana can add more information if I miss anything. But yes, the tollway requires a payment and performance bond for every single contract, regardless of size. And I think it was mentioned as well, but there's also a bid guarantee bond that's required at the time of bid. So if the bid guarantee is required with the bid, payment and performance bonds are required, but they are not required at the time of bid. That's required from the during the contract approval process.
Thank you, Jim. If I want to participate in the Construction Works Apprenticeship Program, what is the process?
So the Construction Works process is part of the A15 subcontractor approval process. This is reviewed by diversity and requires approval prior to that person starting work.
Thank you, Laura. I've got time for one more question after this one. So if you do have something else that you want to ask, please go ahead and type it in the question and answer section or the chat box. How does the contractor submit for a utility locates on tollway projects?
So the contractor must first call Julie, and then with that, the big important piece is that Julie does not locate the tollway fiber, so you must also fill out an A36 process on the tollway's website within 48 hours of that work. This will be covered in more detail at the tollway's pre-construction meeting.
Thanks, Laura. All right, last question. Will the tollway allow a job site trailer or material storage on the project?
So while we typically do not allow trailers on the job site, we do, in special situations, we can approve this, and this would be completed in an A50 process. The A50 process is filled out through eBuilder again, and it'll be reviewed by numerous departments, including maintenance, engineering, our drainage department, and environmental. And so we can review any further requests that way.
Thank you so much, Laura, and everyone on the panel. Kristen, you can take it from here.
Thanks, Lorena. So for the most up-to-date information regarding upcoming contracts and tollway opportunities, please visit the tollway's website at illinoistollway.com, your ultimate resource for doing business with the tollway. Under the Doing Business tab, you'll find information on our diversity programs, like Marlene mentioned. Our technical assistance program and the Small Business Initiative program are both listed under the diversity tab. You can find information under the construction bid letting schedule, professional service bulletins and look aheads, information on the tollways buying plan, information on getting certified and pre-qualified, and additional resources, including our online plan room, videos on submitting bids on tollway work, and how to sign up to receive emails from the IPG when new procurement when new procurement opportunities are available. Thank you again for attending today's presentation. And I want to thank Laura and Marlene for presenting today, as well as all of our panelists for joining us and answering questions. We appreciate all of your participation. And we hope everyone can join us next week for our webinar scheduled Monday, May 10th, and that will cover access to capital. Thank you.